like all the programs we've done together, what's really great is the idea that you can explore this visual artwork while getting a taste of, you know, a totally different art form that was happening during that period. Living as we do, you know, 50, 60 years later, it's all about how do you kind of go halfway back and how do you reincorporate those jettisoned parts of the musical culture. You know, John Cage, right, he really expanded our idea of what music is, right? And so our practice, what Chris and I do when we're not presenting at the Guggenheim as composers and performers, is really massively in debt to him, right? He came up with ideas about changing the way you might make music, the way you might compose music, the way you might play music, but also the idea of putting the listener on the same plane as the performer, the idea that the listener might actually have to work. We're gonna do a graphic score by Earl Brown. Earl Brown very much was about trying to come up with new visual languages for notation that could be, you know, performed. So it's an interesting analog to some of the things that will be hanging on the wall.
Be sure to look up, because he was very influenced by Calder. Yeah. Another aspect of this that I'm very curious about is what the sort of sonic memory of some of the audience people will be afterwards, because they're going to be experiencing it as they're seeing the work on the walls.
Right.
And they might actually pull things from the music that you wouldn't naturally just in a concert hall.